Guys did a great job to let me see the puck. You know, I had the good control. I saw the puck very well. And, it was a complete 60 minutes effort. Solid game, you know, and it's a great start for us. And we're gonna build on it.
How much do you love goaltending battles like that when you and Sorokin are trading big saves early on?
Yeah, it's definitely, it's fun, you know, it's being in NHL, play the game, it's so much fun, you know, and I enjoy this every second.
Oh, yeah, Sorokin's come out as one of the better younger goalies in the league. What do you have to say about his play?
Yeah, he's great. He's a good athletic goalie, good flexibility, mobility, you know, and he came up with a few big saves tonight.
With how hard goals were to come by, what kind of relief was it when you saw Etu get that first one?
Yeah, it's that's kind of this kind of style of the game, you know, like you just stay patient, stay together and wait for a mistake of the opponent.
And celebration, the music blasting in here, how fun is it just to get the first win of the season?
Well, yeah, it's, you know, like winning is fun. Life is better when you win.
Thank you.
Patric, congratulations earlier today that you told us that this team needed to embrace the opportunity ahead of you. You guys certainly did that. How would you characterize this team's performance?
I think if we're playing like this and on a regular basis, we're going to be hard to play against all year. And, you know, we have to give a lot of credit to the Islanders, too. They're hard to play against. They play tight in neutral zone. But you know what? We grind them down. And that says a lot about this team. I know it's only for game one, but at the same time, we started off on the right way.
You had your first goal of the season. What did you see on that play?
No, we rolled over the puck down low, and then they get out to Lombo, and he shot it, and then I get around the net and try to wrap around, and it works, so it was nice.
An eventful game, to say the least. We saw the intensity. We saw the physicality. The power play, excuse me, wasn't necessarily clicking. What needs to be the biggest adjustment moving forward?
No, I think actually they play well on the power play. We didn't get any goals, but they get a lot of scoring chances. And if you keep doing that, I think the puck's going to go on back in the net here.
What will be the focus as you turn the page to Buffalo?
Oh, tomorrow's going to be a recovery day, and then watch the video and see what we can do better. But then, you know, our focus next game is going to be same intensity, same game plan, and same detail.
Patric, thanks so much for the time. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Jess, we'll send it back to you.
I mean, yeah, it's nice to get the first one, but, goal or not, that's how I want to play. It's the team I want to play on, the style we played. Everything was, it's pretty amazing. I was just saying earlier, like, how quick it's taken us just to like gel as a team. And I know after one game, like I feel like I've played with these guys for 10 years, so like it wasn't an adjustment at all. I barely even played in the preseason too, so it's just a credit to all the guys and the environment I'm surrounded in. I'm just so lucky.
What can you say about Bobrovsky's game tonight, especially early on when the game was so tight?
Yeah, incredible. I mean, early on, midway and at the end, he really came up huge for us. And even playing the puck back there, making it easy for the D, I'm very impressed with him tonight.
By all accounts, you're always pretty amped up, or were you especially amped up for your first game as a Panther tonight?
Yeah, probably a little bit extra, but probably a little bit extra.
You had those early opportunities in the first period. You hit the post early, crossbar, I think. You know, how good was it to get that one at the end?
It doesn't matter to me. I'm past that point in my life with caring about that stuff. Like, it's just happy to hear that buzzer go off and us win and get the first one. It's my first time in my career I won the first game. I guess that's pretty cool. So, starting off, can't win all 82 unless you win the first one, right?
And how much are you looking forward to the home game?
Yeah, that's it's a couple games away, but focus on Buffalo. And after hopefully a couple more solid performances from us, then I'll turn to that. But we got a few more before.
You mentioned how quickly this team has been able to gel. What do you attribute that to?
The character, the leaders that have been here before, the younger guys coming up, the environment, the culture. The culture is probably the biggest part of it. And I know they've been building a culture over the last few years. And for me to just easily step into that, like, easily, and I feel like I've been playing here for 10 years with these guys, so they've made it. It's a really big credit to them, and I'm just super lucky.
Paul's talked about that he wants you guys to add some grit to this group, and they brought you in, they brought Mark Stahl in. Do you feel like this group is kind of bought into playing that maybe a defensive style, a more physical style?
Well, I mean, I've never seen it at the end of the game, up two goals and guys going crazy for block shots. the last 30 seconds or minute of the game. So to answer your question, yes, I think guys have bought in, and we have to buy in if we want to win. All we have to do is look at what Tampa's done the last couple of years. I mean, 3, 4, 5 years ago, very run and gun, lots of offense, and never won. But all of a sudden, they changed the way they play a little bit, and still let their skill still allowed to come out. But the way they play, I don't think anybody really talks about like how hard they are to play against, and how disciplined and how physical and dedicated they are to the little parts of the game. So all we have to do is look at them, and I think today was a good start to that.
I think the offense, there was a lot right in front of the net. Like, is that the other part of that, just the kind of gritty goals and stuff like that? Obviously, square reflection.
I've
That's your style.
That's my game. Yeah. So that's easy for me to play. I don't know any other way to play.
And you snuck out a between the leg shot there on a rebound, so you had that skill to it too.
Yeah, but nobody's going to talk about it. Didn't go in. So next time.
Thanks, Matt.
I loved all of it. I mean, in your first game, and really, almost had these guys together for two practices with the injuries and everything that kind of we went through in training camp. They haven't had a lot of time to get together, so I was really happy with it. That team plays a game that got them to the conference finals twice in the last 3 years, and it's a hard game and it's a grinding game, and I thought as the game went on, we got better and better at it, and I'm happy with it. Their goaltender was real good when he needed to be. We didn't score on the power play, but we had some really good looks there. I like the penalty kill. The first one and the third one were just really strong. So I was pretty happy with it.
You mentioned your goaltender, 31 saves for Bobrovsky. How did he affect this game?
Well, when you're putting new things together, there were some strange bounces on some of those, how the puck got to the net, you know. Confidence just builds and grows as the game goes on, right? He just settles guys down. He was really good.
How big is that goal from Patric Hörnqvist to kind of just take the building?
Yeah, right. And because you're saying all the right things on the bench, next shift, you know, and then they come back out and they don't let you're 100% right. You don't let the crowd get going. Bench is back up and excited, so got that good feeling right away. I thought they were really effective, and as I get to know the bench a little more, it was a little unusual by the way the power plays came, the order that they came in. I think that's an effective line, and I think they're going to get more ice time. I'm still learning how to run the bench with this team, right?
Paul, you see Tkachuk try one between the legs on one of his first few shoots of the game. Is that kind of a sign of how good this guy is already feeling with this
group? Well, what do you have, 16 shot attempts tonight? And they're going to go for him. He's got such an incredible stick. I think you had asked me the question about Barkov, the thing that you didn't know. I mean, I knew he had good hands. I didn't know how creative he was with them. His hand skills, his hand-eye coordination are incredible.
He also said that he's felt comfortable from day one. A lot of times guys need a few regular season games to really feel their way in. It doesn't seem that way for him. Why do you think that is?
I think it's the room. And I don't know that I can explain it to you well. My first phone calls in late June, I got off the phone thinking, these guys are all really close and really happy. And I felt the same thing, right? It's a really welcoming group. They want to work. New guys come in. It's a little bit like you've got Barkov, you've got Ekblad, but everybody else kind of came to kind of find their game here. Not that he needed to, but the only way that happens is if you can kind of come in and make friendships and make connections and feel like you're a part of it. So they're good at that. These guys have the right leadership to make new players feel welcome.
How much do you spend in camp on structure and playing the way you need to play in 2-1 to see it tonight?
That was all camp. Yeah. That's all we talked about, really, was, and we've got clearly, you know, lots of room to improve. But the more the messaging and the mindset is you got to enjoy these kind of games. Now, they're no fun in the regular season, especially if you're used to scoring 5 and 6 goals a night. But it looks exactly the way a playoff game is going to be. It's going to be a grinder. You don't get the puck in deep, you're going to pay for it. All those hard things, that's where the area, you know, that's the addition to our game. We think we can still be dynamic off the rush. But we've got to learn how to handle this kind of game.
Did that make the Islanders kind of the ideal opponent for you tonight, since it's a team that's not going to play right. a game where you trade chances. Well, it's going to be a gritty game.
We framed the game in that way, that this is the best possible opponent for us because they're going to play as hard defensively as you're going to see in the NHL, and they're not going to give you anything, and you're going to get frustrated. And they knocked a ton of stuff down on us in the neutral zone, plays that we're kind of used to completing, and you get your odd man rush. But we started to get better and better, and I thought, especially after the first period, we started to be a little smarter with the puck, get a little more offensive zone time. And that the first goal would be kind of exactly the goal that we need to develop an ability to score. We're net front, slot tip, low to high, back of the net. So that was good. It was, for me, it was just a fun bench to be behind because they're serious and they're working and they're very, very intense, but they're also pretty funny. Like there's some funny guys. Hörnqvist is a funny man. So I enjoyed that part, right? You can joke around.
You seem rejuvenated. You feel that?
I was looking for a very specific opportunity, and this was it. My meeting kind of with Bill Zito, about 2 hours in, I'm going, oh, man, I want to get back behind the bench. And then, but you don't know the players, right? You don't know until you get there. Training camp's been fun for me. They worked really, really hard. I pushed them really hard. They handled it just fine. And then they're like, I know it's a bit of a younger team in some ways, but they're all men, right? They enjoy their jobs. They go outside. They enjoy the weather. It's pretty good.
Going back to Matthew, he's obviously such a big personality, but right. Just now he's taking a picture with Barkov at the puck. Like, yeah. How important is that he came in and, you know, Barkov is the cat? Like, what?
So there would be, there's the on-ice person and the off-ice person. The thing that you know, he was here about a week and he had already taken all the trainers out for dinner. Right? He's a very giving person. If a kid wants an autograph, he's a very caring, kind and caring human being. And then he's a pain in the ass when he gets on the ice, right? So that's good for the Florida Panthers fans to know the kind of man that he is. He takes care of people.
And it looked like this was the type of game you guys brought Matthew Tkachuk in. I mean, how was it to watch him dominate that style of game?
Well, he's real good, right? Hash marks down in the offensive zone. He's those hand skills, but he positions his body. He's clearly not afraid of hanging out down there. He's got a little bit of edge when he bumps into people. Yeah, that's the player. We gotta get the range finder going on some of those shots, and he'll do well.
Thanks, guys.